Hi, I'm Professor Tom Raimondo. I'm the Dean of Programs for Information Technology and Mathematics at the University of South Australia. Globally, mining is becoming an increasingly difficult endeavour for a lot of companies because of the difficulty of locating economic deposits. Essentially, they are deeper than they have ever been, so there's a lot more challenge to actually image them and discover them. They're also a lot more complex in terms of processing them to extract the metals and other resources that you need. What virtual and augmented reality can do is give us a better way to visualize and interpret the data that allows us to make good decisions about where we should be targeting our exploration efforts and what we might expect when we do start to explore those assets. Explorers often deal with very complex data and a lot of data as well. So we're talking about continental scale data sets, spatial information that encompasses multiple layers of detail and so on. And it's often got a three-dimensional or even a four-dimensional aspect to it as well. Now, when you're trying to view that information in a traditional desktop environment, it's very problematic. You lose some of the fidelity in the data, if you like. But when you view it in an immersive environment that you can do with virtual reality in particular, all of that spatial information is preserved, the fidelity of the data is preserved, and you can view it in a much more authentic way. A digital twin is something that authentically replicates a physical object or a process. So you're trying to completely capture all the elements of that thing or that process in a digital environment so that you can then run a whole bunch of simulations or you can modify a process a little bit, for example, and see what the effect is. You're basically trying to simulate a whole bunch of outcomes and get the response or get the output that you're looking for by running it multiple times. So a digital twin saves you having to run all those things in the real world by allowing you to very efficiently run them in the virtual world, if you like. So I can see a whole suite of applications across a bunch of industries. Some of the ones that we're working with currently are across forestry, construction, even the Country Fire Service, for example, looking at fire management and risk analysis and that sort of thing. The potential's there for any industry, essentially, that has a need for simulating some kind of environment in a digital sense to adopt this technology. I think what we'll find is that most mining operations will be done remotely and done by autonomous machines. So we'll have much less transit of people between a central office, for example, and the remote operations. So the logistics will become a lot simpler. I think you'll have all of the mine planning done in a digital twin, for example. So you'll have a lot of the plans for mine expansion, modeling of the ore resource, all of that sort of stuff that's done in a purely digital environment and viewed immersively. So you get a true 3D representation of the entire mine operations, all of the extraction, all of the processing, all of the transport, all of that sort of stuff can effectively be simulated in a totally immersive 3D environment.